Hello everyone, this is Professor Shaista Khanam from Vidyavardhini's College of Engineering and Technology. In last videos, I have explained you about the passive component and active component. Now we, as we understood about components, so now we'll see if I want to use those components and if I want to give some signal, how to give signal. So signal can be of different types and different instruments can be used to supply the signal. And after supplying the signal, I want to measure in my circuit that what is the voltage, what is the current, how the waveform will look, that I can measure using the measuring equipment. So now we'll see different measuring instrument and signal source. Now before going to this, first of all we should clear our voltage. What are the different types of voltage sources we have? Now here we have voltage sources. This is nothing but unipolar and bipolar. Unipolar is nothing but DC, and this can be DC, can be your batteries, it can be a power supply, and bipolar is nothing but AC. AC is nothing but a signal generator. So this DC, what is the main difference between DC and AC? In DC we have fixed voltages, and in AC we have alternating voltages. And in DC the frequency is zero, whereas in AC we have frequency. So when you may mention AC, for example, if you consider your main supply, so main supply is 230 volt 50 hertz. So when you see two parameters are specified, voltage and frequency. Whereas if you consider a battery, suppose if you are buying a battery of 3 volt, so when you buy a battery, along with that only you mention the battery, means how much voltage you need. Along with that, you are not mentioning any current or any frequency. So this AC signal, and one more thing, when you draw the symbol, in a symbol we are not showing a plus symbol, we are not showing plus or minus, because it as it is changing, we cannot mention the polarity. But when you consider DC, in DC we have polarity as plus and minus. Next is ground. So for ground, there is a ground procedure is there. With the help of that, signal is properly grounded. So for grounding is providing a reference with respect to ground, we are going to measure all the voltages. Next, the first measuring instrument is digital multimeter. Digital multimeter, we are using it for the measurement of resistance, current and voltage. It is used for continuity testing and measuring the transistor beta value. Now resistance, you can see this is one form of multimeter I am showing. This is a selector switch. By changing this selector switch, you can select the options which are available in a multimeter. Here you can see it is showing voltage. So we can measure voltage of two types, AC voltage and DC voltage. We can measure resistance. You can measure AC current, you can measure DC current. Here it is also showing, this is continuity beeper and this is for measurement of frequency. But in all the multimeter, this all the features are not available. So like what we have in our lab, in that we don't have frequency measurement. What is continuity beeper? Continuity beeper is nothing but if you want to check that the wire is not broken inside, because it's having an insulator. So if you want to check whether it is means it's there is no breakage inside, so you can check the wire. Two wires connection can be connected to the multimeter two ends, and if it is properly connected, there is no breakage, there is no open circuit, so it will give you a bit. This indicate that wire is proper. And these are the knobs, and this is the common knob. And normally black is used for the common, and the red we are changing it for depending upon what you want to measure. If you want to measure, suppose resistance, so for measurement of resistance, you can see you cannot connect multimeter directly into the circuit, because if you connect it in a circuit, it will not measure the nearby resistances also. Circuit resistance will also affect the resistance over here. If you want to measure the resistance, then you need to remove the resistor and you can connect the multimeter like this. And you can measure the resistance. You can use a multimeter also for measuring voltages and current. Voltage, if you want to measure voltage, you can directly connect a meter in parallel to this resistor. But if you want to measure a current, then it should be in series, because this current is passing through a closed loop. So when the loop is completing, so the loop is completing through the multimeter. And these are the different selectors. These are the different ranges. Here it is nothing but 20 volt, 200 volt, 1000 volt. These are the different ranges. Suppose if you are measuring 100 volt and you are keeping it on 20 volt range, then this multimeter will show you only one. One doesn't mean it is showing 1 volt. That one means indicate that your position of the selector is, that means your range is exceeding. You need to change the range from 20 to 200 volt, then it will show you the value. Next is function generator. Function generator is nothing but a signal source, which is, we can say it is an AC signal source. It can generate different type of AC signal with different amplitude, different frequency, and different type of waveform. So here you can see on a display, it is showing some voltage level, it is showing frequency, and it is showing this sinusoidal waveform. See, this is a digital one, hence it is showing all the things. Otherwise, if you see this one, here it is showing only, here I can see the frequency value. I cannot see rest of the thing, what are the selections and everything, and amplitude also it is not showing. So this is nothing but range of frequencies, and with the help of this level knob, you can adjust the amplitude, and you can see sine, triangle, square. These are the different options for selecting the different types of AC signal. This knob is used for reducing the voltage, and this coarse and fine is for changing the frequency. So this is generating a frequency of, this is generating a signal of variable frequency from hertz to megahertz, and amplitude also from the very small millivolts to volts. So you can take out the voltage from using the probes over here. So these are nothing but different types of waveform: sine wave, square wave, triangular wave, and sawtooth waveform, which can be generated by using the function generator. Now next is power supply. Power supply, this is a DC regulated power supply. This is a DC signal source. It can give you a DC voltage. Of here it is showing a variable voltage. So if you want a variable voltage, you can take it from here. If you want a fixed voltage of 5 volt, then you can take it from here also. So in this power supplies, there are some fixed voltages. Here also they have plus minus 15 volt also. In power supply, one important thing is that every power supply is having a current rating. What is the significance of a current rating? Suppose if this power supply is having a current rating of 2 ampere, this means that if you are connecting any circuit, so it can give, this power supply can give maximum of 2 ampere of current. So that is nothing but what a current limit of a power supply. So power supplies are available in different current ranges: 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 5 ampere. So depending upon the application, you can use it. Next is CRO. CRO is used. The function generator will give you the AC signal, but if you want to observe the what signal it is given, because it is not showing exactly what signal is. So that that signal you can observe on a CRO. So CRO is used for measurement of frequency, amplitude, phase. It is also used for component testing. Also, by using Lissajous pattern, you can measure the, you can see the component component behavior. You can measure the phase differences also. This is a CRO we have in our lab. This is two channel CRO of 20 megahertz signal. So maximum frequency of a signal which I can observe on the CRO is 20 megahertz. Two channel CRO means I can observe two channels. You can see over here how it is showing. This is showing sinusoidal waveform, and this is straight line. So this is also, here also I can show one more signal, but here it is, it's just a display, so it is not showing. But you can connect, if you connect a signal on both the channels, then it will give you the display. And by using, see here, time, there is a time division knob and voltage division knob. This voltage division knob for individual channel, and time division knob is common for both the channels. How to measure time period and voltage, that I have put up a link of a video in which I have explained how to measure it. So you can just go through that video and you'll come to know how to measure the frequency and the time period by using CRO. This is a CRO probe which is used for doing the connection. This is a prototyping board. What is prototyping board? Prototyping board is nothing but, see, you have component, you have signal source, you have measuring it. So if you want to do the connection, you want to form a circuit, so this board is used for connecting a circuit. This is called as power bar line. Power bar, this is for VCC and this is for ground. You can interchange also. These are the columns. These power bars are horizontally shorted, whereas these columns are vertically shorted. And where you can observe the gap, this gap indicates, see, this and this is not connected. This and this is not connected. If you want to do any connection, here if you want to do any connection, then you need to do a connection horizontally. Or either you can connect one terminal of a resistor over here and one terminal of a resistor over here. So that means there is a gap, this indicates. Resistor is not shorted, but here if you connect the resistor in one line only, then this is shorted. This power bar line are very useful because if you connect, suppose if you are taking a VCC, why it is power bar? If you will take a VCC line, you will connect it on one point. If you are connecting it to one point, this means this the whole line will become VCC. So how many wires, if you want to take wires, you can take many points are available for doing this oversupply connection. And similarly, you can have a ground connection also. If you are connecting a ground, this whole line will become ground, and hence it is forming a so big ground connection. And here you can do the circuit connection. Here resistor is connected, one end is connected over here, another end you can connect it anywhere over here or anywhere over here. This is nothing but, in this way we can do the connection. Here I have shown the LED. You can see this LED is connected. This is a gap. So this LED, one end is anode is connected over here, cathode is connected over here. This is a resistor. Here I have shown a power. This with the help of battery I have shown a connection. See here, what they are doing? They are forming this line. This line is nothing but what? This is a ground connection. So from here it is, they are taking this wire over here. You can see they are taking this wire over here, and this is also ground. So as this ground wire is connected over here, this whole line is shorted. That means yahan se from the cathode, if you are connecting it over here, that means this whole line is nothing but a ground connection. And how we are forming a plus positive connection? Red is connected to this line, second line. So second line pe resistor is connected. And hence it is forming a power supply. So from here they are taking this line. So this line can be used for giving the plus of the supply. So for in order to extend the circuit, this can be used. So this is the example how the breadboard connection can be done. And the best thing, you need to take the component, you need to do it by yourself, then only you'll have a practical experience. If you do it by your hand, you'll understand better. So this is just an introduction. So try to do these connections and take the feel of it. Thank you so much.